Morning Rat fans! We are off to Adventure Bike Festival. We have an African Twin and a Honda CRF in front of us. There's Colin at the front on the CRF and his friend on the African Twin. We are meeting someone at A34. Shall we go? And there'll be a convoy of four of us. Glued me a throttle. And it seems to be a bit more responsive now. I'd lost my rock straps somehow. So, yeah, God knows where they've gone. I've got the little ones. So I've used those to strap on. Me sleeping about me tent and that, and then I've used the bungee net in my arse to keep the sleeping bag on. So I swear I put them all outside on the bike last night. The little ones were there, but not the big ones. Maybe somebody walked off with the big ones, I don't know. Or using them on my fishing gear to keep my bed chair and everything attached to my trolley.
Alright, we have just met Tony at the A34. Got some fuel. Had a nice voucher come through for £3.40 off of fuel today.
Sitting here, I got time, it's clear to see from up here. The world seems small, we can sit together, it's so beautiful, you and me. Meant to be in the great outdoors, forever free.
We made it!
It's Contract Productions, hey!
Thank you.
This is my favorite part, right here. Made it to Ragley Hall. This is our camp. These four here. Yeah, it's a bit windy. We've got here fun trying to put the tents up. Colin lost his tent over the manufacturer trail. So that was fun for him. Get in the back. Filled up some water. They've all gone to the shop. Now I'm just gonna have a walk in and see what's going on. Maybe that's a bridge, part of the Bridgestone Trail, or maybe. Yeah, weird. That's bad. Right, let's go for a wander.
At San Andreas Uni in Bolivia, the Bolivian salt flats, that just so happened to be the one day of the entire ride around the world that we were both camping.
I do agree with you, and I think it was suggested to me, and it sort of just became an excuse to do it, and it definitely wasn't the reason I kept going, because that's frankly not a good enough reason, like you said.
Exactly.
And I think people that get really caught up in the record that, like, it just, like, it dragged me down. I don't know how it felt for you guys, but it just...
Do a bit of trail riding now. Just got one of these cool covers to go on the bike. Tried it yesterday, quite nice. Then the guy, when we got back to 10 this evening, he had a Himalayan one on, tried it, he recommended it. So a few recommendations, so I thought we'll give it a go. So now,
right, there we go.
Now to get onto the trails.
Cool, alright, cheers. Main trail. Woohoo! Expert on there. Ding, 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 ding. Thank you. gate there.
GoPro Hero 12. Excellent.
I'm going to ask any nasty questions, and that's actually quite a nice start.
Thank you. And it's absolutely true as well. We've taken to heart some of the things you said to us when we first met you in 2000?
In 2000.
So we've had a long, long relationship. And I'm sure it's actually been more to our advantage than it has ever been to Sam.
The first question we asked Sam, I mean, we'd never been off-road, we were complete newbies. We said, Sam, we want to go around the world. What's the most important thing we should take? His answer was this. Of all the tools you can carry, the most important one is the tool to be able to be flexible. I think you worded it slightly more succinctly, but you said, be flexible in your expectations and be flexible when you travel. After that, everything is great. And it was absolutely true. If you try and be too rigid, if you try to make the journey fit your expectations, chances are it's going to fail. But that one piece of advice has served us so well for all our time on the road.
Oh, If I'm not back again this time tomorrow, carry on, nothing really matters.
Guys, we're at the BMW stand. I got myself a ride booked on GS1300. Fortunately, 900 was fully booked by the time I got through to the checkout. So I just went through and got any bike there. So 956, there we go. That's gonna be my beast. So we've got an hour trail ride in. So yeah. Hello there. Right. We're on a BMW. Last day today, it's Sunday. Just after 7. Been up since about 5:30, 6 ish. People are queuing already for like stuff. Thought I'd come down and have a look, see what's going on. Didn't do much filming and stuff yesterday, mainly because I didn't charge my phone much yesterday. It was dead quite early on. Went on the trail, but same trail, so didn't record it. Was an extra bit at the end that I didn't do last time. Did have a little off, just stationary again on the rut, just dropped it on the rut when I was stopping. And bent my handlebars a little bit. And yeah, gave something a mild concussion. I was a bit discombobulated for the rest of the day. Oh, I didn't do much filming yesterday. Rained a little bit overnight, so it's a bit damp. Otherwise, good. So yeah, just having a wander around this morning. Guys were out at about 6 to get breakfast and stuff in the queue. So I'm gonna see if I can find them. And yeah, then just after lunch, probably start heading home. So I'll catch up with you in a bit. All right, we've just booked a quick test ride on I'll see you there, gas. And that, queuing Tony and Pete for a bit. Fortunately, they don't have the right boots, they've just got like walking, hiking boots sort of thing. Whereas you need to have motocross boots or veg boots as a minimum. Lucky I have those. So, damn it, fuck it, whatever. I've queued up with them for half hour, 40 minutes. And that, I thought, oh, we'll do a ride out together rather than just going on the Ducati stand and having a go at one of those. And I thought, yeah, I'll book it. Got that booked for 9:30. So I'm just wandering down to the shop, get a can of Monster, give myself some caffeine and boost.
and I'll walk back up, get my gear, and yeah, get to come back up and get ready for that. It's enduro bikes, nice lightweight. Give it a go. So yeah, so catch you then.
Right, we're having a go on a gas. It's a flash. Not really in two strokes, it's about 16, 17. Fuck me, this is fucking knackering, but so much fun. Me. Fucking like jump over, there's like nothing there, and you hit the other one. It's like, whoa! Fuck!
A
wheelie it up! Excellent! Alright guys, we just walked back down to the Ineos stand now. Filming on my old GoPro because I'm going to strap it to the outside of the Jeep thingy, and if I lose it I'm not as worried. Got the main man on the gate there, he's here day and night, raise and shine. Hey, hey.
Yeah.
He's the man. Lovely lady here. Hope they bring you tea and coffee all day.
Some punters just come in and they said, if you have a cup of coffee, I went, no, sort of bringing one back.
Oh, that's nice.
Some punter put a hat on my head. It could say fuck off, I don't know.
No, I think you're all right. You said, yeah.
The management bought me these gloves.
Oh, okay. Only on the last day.
Yeah, but then I haven't needed these any other day, have I?
Yeah, it's been quite warm, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Should have had you an umbrella to attach. Nice little parasol.
Yeah.
Ah, get someone with a 3D printer like me to make you something to clip on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That'd be good.
No worries, have fun.
Right, as you can see, that was a gas. One little off going up the hill because I couldn't see because of the dust, and then got a bit of air, didn't warn us as a drop bit. Completely cleared it. Apparently I was on one wheel all the way up that hill, so that was fun. Absolutely knackered now. So now we're at the Ineos stand. What the Land Rover should have been. Give that a go. And yeah, get back and start tidying up, packing up. Come up here, kill some time for an hour, then head home.
So yeah, so that's it. What do I think of my first ABR Fest? Good, tiring, painful on occasions, entertaining. Yeah, you got to be up early in the morning if you want to get some good test rides. Hopefully the gas footage I've got will be absolutely awesome. We'll find out later in the week. Yay! That was tiny, everybody! Weekend, you're the man, Tony. If you're watching this, you're the man. You're fucking awesome. Loved company, mate. You were an absolute laugh and a legend. Yep, so he's going back to Brighton now. We're heading back to us, Pete Marshwood. Up to Roundham's now.
There you go, people, we're home. I am completely dusty. Harold is completely dusty. He needs a good clean. I need a bath. We made it. What a bloody weekend it was. And I get in, get sorted myself, get changed out my bike gear, and then empty the bike out and sort the bike out. And then, yep, won't worry about cleaning the home. Gonna have a nice bath, roast dinner, Formula One. Till the next video, catch you later, peace out.